Hello everyone, this is Gaith. In this lesson, we will see how we can start creating a new iOS application that uses the DJI SDK that we connect to and get a feedback on the registration status, as it is the most important step if you want to develop a fully integrated DJI mobile app. I got already my Xcode project is opened here and a simulator. Now, if you initiate a new pod file and type inside it pod DJI SDK iOS, since we will be using this SDK, the DJI SDK in our project, so we needed to install it, installing it using CocoaPods. So go ahead and create a new pod file project and place this line of code or this line here, and then go to your terminal, to your project, and then type pod install. Wait a minute and then you will get your DJI SDK iOS integrated and installed in your project. Now, to make sure that the SDK is working, you have to import it in your view controller and then build command to see if the SDK is connecting or working correctly in your environment. Yeah, so the build is succeeded. Now to communicate with the server, DJI server, we need a protocol which is called DJI SDK. SDK manager delegate. If you want your view controller to follow this protocol, you have to import or to follow these two functions. I prefer putting them below the viewDidLoad function. For the time being, we will not be using this function, just ignore it, and we will just be depending on the result of this function, which that is checking if we get back an error or not. So now we have to create another function that says register app. In this function here, we will be calling the DJI SDK manager and say register app on self on this view controller. Now, if you check this function explanation, it says the first time the app is initialized after installation, the app connects to a DJI server through the internet to verify the application key. Where is the application key? We don't have any application key yet. We will be creating that in a few seconds after we finish our code. So first, let's call this function from the viewDidLoad here, register app. And after we call this register app function, the callback will be in here, and then we will get the result of the calling. And after the DJI server will check for us the DJI SDK app key if it is matching correctly or not. So we got the error. Now, here we will type some logic. Define a new var message, and inside this message we will say register app succeed maybe. Now, if error is not equal to null, what does that mean? This means that if there is an error, if we got an error, then we change the message context to register app failed, please enter your app key in the list file and check the network. Yeah. Else we could print out some statement that says, for example, register app success. Now let's create another function that will show a pop-up message for us. Show alert view, for example, with title, for example, let's say with title, we have here definition with title and inside title of type string, and then with the message, the inside message is also of type string, and inside logic here is about defining an alert of type UI alert controller with title, the same title we pass here, and a message, the same message we pass here, and the preferred style is alert. And let, for example, okay action, we need an action here to close the pop-up message, which is UI alert action with a title, for example, okay, and the style default, and here just nil for the handler. Now we can add for the alert controller a new action, which is okay action, and then we can display this action on the screen. We can say, yeah, of course, the alert animated true and completion is nil. Now if you run this app as it is, we should get the alert view function or pop-up alert view without any success for the app key. Yeah, but here first we have to call it here with the message, and yeah, with message, sorry, the message should be goes here as the logic. Yeah, and the title should be here, for example, let's say the title is register app. Yeah, run again. Yeah, so it says register app failed. Please enter your app key in the plist file and check the network. So we don't have yet the, okay, we will do that. We don't have yet the DJI SDK app key here. So we have to go to the website of the DJI. You can get to the account, DJI.com, and register a new developer account if you don't have one from here. I already got my own, so I will be creating a new app under the SDK, Mobile SDK, and the app name, for example, let's say test. You can type here whatever you want and choose iOS. Now here the bundle identifier should be the same as this app bundle identifier. So you can get it from here, I guess, yeah. So paste it here, and then for category, you can choose whatever you want, and here just type test, create one. So after you creating it, the DJI will send you an email that has the activation account or activation email that says, just open it and you will be redirected to this page As you can see here, if I refresh, I will get the app key. So copy this app key and go to the info.plist and then just add this key under something called DJI SDK app key. And put it here. Sorry, I will do it again. DJI SDK. Why I'm getting S at the beginning? DJI SDK app key, and then paste this string here. Yeah, make sure to type all of these capital and then small double P, and then the K is capital and then small E E Y. Okay, and place this key here and run again. Now the communication should be done correctly. Register app is succeeded. So this is the first lesson. See you in the next one. Thank you.